You want to take the Hummer first?
I want to see what happens. Yeah.
Fine, I'll game on my stuff first before I send them in. Let's go for it.
Here she comes. I think she's coming. Yep, here she comes.
Good morning, boys and girls, and welcome back to the channel. If you guys are new to the channel, I am Senna Steve. Over here, we've got my buddy Spencer, top line racer. We'll get you in there. There we go. We got Spencer here.
A little bit, man.
We got his brother here. We're going to go out here and do a little off-roading here at the farm. We're just going to play around a little bit, see what we can get into. Nothing too crazy, but I am super curious to see if the Hummer will be able to hang with the XJ on some of these obstacles.
Oh, man. It crushes
James. Yeah.
You have no idea.
Yeah, you guys should see some of the comment section. Again, go over, follow him, top line racer. In the comment section on his one, what was it, H2 or Hummer versus
Jeep? Yeah, I mean, that's what I said. Yeah, I said it crushes Jeeps out on the trail.
Yeah.
And it wasn't true, but it made a good title.
It definitely made a good thumbnail and a good title, but definitely go check him out. The comment section is hilarious. You got to go check it out. But we're going to go over here and just do some basic things. And I got a little bit of a mud pit that I was scared to go in by myself. I did go through it, but I didn't go to the deep section because I didn't want to winch out and I was in my Crocs. So now that we have another recovery vehicle, let's just try it.
And we do have a winch along.
We have a winch. I got my winch. I should be able to pull you out.
We sort of have a winch, actually.
Yeah.
We just switched out from a top post battery. The top post battery died, so we have no way to hook it up. But yeah, we have it along.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Well, that's fine. Yeah. Well, here goes nothing.
Dude, it just crawls over it. Yeah. Wow.
And this is what I was telling him.
Oh, yeah.
I don't want him to get in.
Yeah.
This thing won't.
Gnarly little hill here. I love it. A lot of people like talk a bunch of crap on it saying it's nothing, but you guys quickly learn it's a little more than nothing, but still kind of nothing.
Yeah. Well, so. I mean, it's for something just like around. Man.
Yeah.
And cameras suck, man.
Yeah, definitely.
The cameras suck. The dip and the angle.
Yeah. All right. I'm going to get the Jeep out of here and we're going to keep on keeping on. Our second obstacle for the Humvee here, or Hummer, sorry, not Humvee.
Oh,
I better, yeah, I better not call it a Humvee. Holy cow! Yeah. For the H2, we'll see if it can go up this. Now, I did make it in this, and my F350 almost made it, but
okay.
You can try to crawl it if you want. I just can't crawl it. You might have the weight.
Should air down, probably.
Yeah, see, I have to keep it moving a little bit.
That's cheap, man.
Yeah.
You might even high-center it, Tom. I don't know.
Videos, again, never do justice, but that's probably 20 feet in the air right there.
It is quick.
Yeah.
All right, here we go.
There it is.
All right, here goes the jump. Oh. Just not enough power to get the air, man. Alright.
Nice.
Yeah. Well, I've decided that I'm gonna try this. I didn't want to try it alone. But since we have technically a recovery vehicle here, not that the Jeep's not self-sufficient, but we have a recovery vehicle, we have other bodies. Let's just go for it.
I like it, man.
You wanna take the Hummer first?
I want to see what happens. Yeah.
Fine, I'll gamble my stuff first before I send them in. Let's go for it.
You then earn from here.
I'm gonna just
come down the side
and just try to nose in.
Got it. So Steve is gonna try out something.
Mud truck. So for everybody that says I built this for a mud truck, it is not a mud truck. It is a rock crawler, which we'll do up here. You'll see.
Steve's working on getting into this little bit of water over here. It doesn't look real deep, but the entry and exit could be a problem. He asked if we wanted to take the Hummer, and we were like, nah, not for right now. We're gonna let the Jeep go first. That looked tight for the Hummer. Like that.
Entirely too easy.
I'll tell you what, that thing crawls like amazing, man.
Definitely. I gotta give Rough Country a huge shout out on building this thing with me. It is insane the things that it does with ease. Like going in there, it did feel a little sketchy inside, but I've never gone in there. So I think that was really why I felt sketchy. But the thing felt so level. It felt strong. It felt good. I wasn't worried at all.
Yeah, that first part, we were up here looking like, it's not a joke.
Slid the nose in a little, I was like, oh, it's good. Once I felt that tire come back down on the ground, then I was like, oh, we're good.
Yeah. All right, man, go ahead.
Can I do it?
Yeah, go ahead, man.
You want me to move a little bit?
Because yeah,
I'm
probably for
the momentum whenever I come out. Yeah.
Just watch, like, on the other, there's another bowl like this right here.
Okay.
So just, like, hang left. I'll park my Jeep here, just hang to the left of the Jeep.
Got it.
Whoo! Seems like you might be catching an inner fender a little bit. Yeah, there you go. Too bad.
That's not shabby. That's not shabby. The first was a little sketchy.
Just hit it, man.
The danger zone is past now.
Now you don't have much room to back up.
Yeah, because you slid over.
But you can come back a little bit if you want to try to reposition the front wheels.
would turn.
Get enough speed to hop that rock.
I would turn left. Turn the other way. Yep.
And hold it about there.
And now I would hang left. Yep, hang left.
For grip.
You're gonna need a little momentum to get over the rock under the left rear.
Rocker
pound. Hold on one second. Yeah, sure.
Hold on one second. I don't know if I can pick this up.
But I think hold on.
Oh, yeah.
Buddy, I can do that. I don't want to see you mess yourself up. That might actually help you step up it, though. All right.
A little easier on him.
Yeah, man.
Well, or help him high center.
Now we're
Now it's a commitment. You back up and I'll go get the winch and pull you forward, or
just keep coming back till I'll tell you when. Keep coming.
Hold on one sec. I'll stack a couple rocks.
Just don't tell everybody at Rouse Creek we're stacking rocks.
I think you're gonna be all right now once you get up over this rock. I think you got a good shot, buddy.
Should do that one more time.
Yeah, maybe. Yep.
Going.
Has
no low end.
I know.
Stop.
All right, you still locked? Just make sure. Sometimes it kicks out. Okay.
All right, here we go.
All right.
Oh, I think she's beached.
I think now she's on that rock completely. I mean, there goes the fuel tank.
Is that what it was?
The front definitely lifted a little on that one. I can pull you forward with my winch if you want to go forward.
Yeah, it might be where we are, actually. I'm thinking.
Unless I try to winch this rock out of here.
I
want this rock moved anyway, but it's whatever you think. Yours.
I think to get out of this thing, I think anything we do backwards is gonna be right in the fuel tank.
Okay.
You know what I mean? I think this way here we actually skid over top the rear axle.
Okay.
And I
Deal.
Think that's the safer way.
I think so too.
I just don't want to lose daylight. We're not really in any kind of city lighting, so we have no light there.
Here she comes. I think she's coming. Yep, here she comes. Now you are.
Easy.
Woo!
My alternator is pissed.
Yeah, your battery and alternator are done, man. Rattlesnake or something.
Rattlesnake
No?
Rattlesnake was the one that was real rocky.
It was all rocky for like a mile.
We did Copperhead or something like that afterwards.
Snake bite?
Snake, I don't know.
I don't know.
The one where the whole freaking roof got taken out.
Oh. Yeah, camel something or other.
Camel's back.
Camel's back?
That's right. Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah, camelback.
And there was a section where you had to go between two trees as you're turning and over a hill, and we could not fit physically between the two trees on either side.
Oh, you're out of a tire there, bud.
Yeah, that's what...
I didn't see it. Okay.
Oh, yeah, that's what happened, man. Oh. This one here? Yeah.
But that's because they ordered me a... that's why. I forgot I had that fan sitting here running. But I had the axles for this on order. I had... the Yukon stuff on order.
For sure, the armor?
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
This pump has saved 30 guys on the trail, at least.
Yeah, it actually looks like good, like, shop quality, but for a portable.
I could have probably got a couple boyfriends behind this pump. Everybody was so excited. They were like, dude, we've been trying. Like, four people showed up. The only people that really could do it was, like, onboard air.
I think she is.
Again, I know I said it five times in this video.
studio. Huge shout out to Rough Country for everything they've done. They make stuff like this possible. I wouldn't have this pump if it wouldn't be for Rough Country. Like, hands down. I wouldn't have the Jeep built as good as, it is without Rough Country. I can't thank them enough.
Dude, I'm sorry. This whole time, I'm so used to doing camera commentary for him and like not being a silent cameraman. So when you get all this stuff, you're like, crap, that guy talks all the time.
Yeah, no,
but I'm used to reacting to his stuff, and he's like, cameramen don't usually do that. I was like, oh, my bad.
It don't matter.
It's like, you get what you pay for.
Yeah. The Jeep is
I think she's about ready to pop right now, man. That's cool. That's crazy.
And they're actually not that expensive. Like, they're $149.
Okay.
Knowing what this thing is, if I had to get one, and I was in the market for one, I wouldn't buy one of the $70 ones. I'd just go buy one of these right out of the beginning. You know?
There she goes.
Let's get back out there.